Welcome to Mint Views. Today we are going to talk about a very peculiar deal that has been struck between the United States of America and the Taliban in Afghanistan. We all know the parties involved. The interesting part of this deal is that the Taliban more or less get what they want. The US is withdrawing its troops. They plan to exit Afghanistan in 14 months in stages. Sanctions on the Taliban will be lifted, and many of their prisoners, according to the deal, are to be freed. What the US gets is slightly different. The Taliban promises to behave itself, more or less. What that means is they will cooperate with the government, elected government of Afghanistan. They will not give sanctuary to terrorists, and they will press and try and maintain peace in Afghanistan. Whether or not they're going to adhere to that promise, that's the whole question, because we know what the Taliban is. Broadly, it's looking more or less like a surrender agreement on part of the United States, and that's a big problem for countries like India. Will they hold to this deal or will they not? What does this mean for India? That's what we want to talk about, and Shrija will begin. Let us know what you think.
Yeah, Arish, actually the deal that you mentioned, the Doha Accord, more or less looks like actually a compromise rather than a deal per se. Because you see, when the Taliban, but the given the history of Taliban since the 2001 attacks, we've been known they've been sheltering and harboring terrorists and fomenting violence in the region. So with this deal, just to expect that they will hold the end of the bargaining, or they will actually adhere to the bargaining, is actually could be farcical in the sense. And also the fact is a foreign prescription of peace brought in by the US, will it actually work in a country which has been striven by civil conflict? This actually, poses a very big question whether this deal will actually work for Afghanistan.
Much of the problem here is the Taliban itself, who has no respect for human rights from what we have seen of their record. The period that they actually had direct control of Afghanistan was a horror. And in particular, their lurid and primitive interpretation of Islam in particular is a major problem there. Shrija, what do you make of this? Are they going to hold?
That will be difficult to say at this juncture because, as you rightly pointed out, concepts and values of democracy, human rights are alien to the Taliban. And we have seen the horrors that they have inflicted on the Afghan society when they ruled Afghanistan from 1996 to 2001. But more importantly, what does it mean for India? Taliban sees India as a hostile force because India actually supported the Northern Alliance, which was fighting against the Taliban in the early 90s. So to that extent, they would also be kind of they will not be amenable to India's interests so far as Afghanistan is concerned. Also, we all know how Pakistan and the ISI plays the role of a benefactor to the Taliban. To that extent, I think the Taliban would be detrimental to our interests in Afghanistan.
Mm-hmm. So Anand, what do you think? It looks like America has basically left Afghanistan to the Taliban. That's a horror, isn't it? What do you think?
Yeah. America is saying, look guys, we are out of here. Now you handle it on your own. I think they've got their priorities somewhere else. In fact, if you see, there's been a statement today from their defense secretary that they need to focus their efforts, their military efforts on others, countering China perhaps and focusing the military strength in other regions. So Afghanistan is not on their top priority list at all. So they're just getting out of it. Now others in the region have to deal with the situation. And as you mentioned, it's at the end of the day a ragtag, militia group that has come up. So you really can't expect them to uphold the kind of values that countries like India and other democracies uphold. It'll be a very difficult path ahead.
Yeah, it's a loose bunch. The Taliban literally means students, but their understanding of anything, let alone Islam, seems to be ridiculous. They have no understanding. They're a bunch of people encouraging violence. Their record is terrible. What do you think? What will happen now? What do we do? What does India do in this situation?
So, Arish, India's policy towards Afghanistan always been, Afghan-led, Afghan-controlled, and which talked about the democracy and the inclusivity of the Afghan government within the process. So this deal actually, you know, subtracts the participation of the government, of the Afghan government, which is actually very unfortunate, because and given the fact that India has never accorded recognition of the Taliban as a state actor, as a legitimate actor that could play you know, its operations in upholding governance and values of Afghanistan. So it tells you that India, the deal nonetheless could potentially spell disaster for India, given that India also has a major geopolitical stake in the region, which mm-hmm. Chabahar port and everything else.
That's right. It may end up a battle for control within Kabul between Indian and Pakistani forces, in I don't mean in a direct sense.
Proxies, basically.
Yeah. Do you think that might unfold,
Srijay? That could unfold, but you know what, Arish, all is not lost for India in Afghanistan. Mm-hmm. You see, India has made investments in developing the physical infrastructure there, and that has earned India a lot of goodwill among the locals there, and especially among the Pashtuns, who are a majority population in Afghanistan, and some of them also have links with the Taliban. So therefore, even if we do not directly talk to the Taliban, there are indirect linkages, there are indirect kind of contacts we can have with the Taliban. So India can use that lever. And also, if you look at how despite Pakistan being pressured into helping the US to bring the Taliban on the negotiating table, the US has not really helped Pakistan get off the FATF grey list. So that carrot and stick policy will continue to remain, and that can help India's causes in Afghanistan.
Do you think there's hope in that, Anand?
No, I don't think so. I think he's right that there is a minor lever there, but it's not going to be a big lever simply because of the fact that, during the negotiations of the peace deal also, India wasn't really participating, not by choice, but it was kept out. So it didn't really have a role over there. And now whatever is happening over there is without the involvement of India. So we just have to go with what is being given to us as in, a hostile environment. So I think the situation is bad. We had traditionally decent relations, people-to-people relationship with the Afghanistan, with the Afghanis. But the forces that have ruled that country have always dominated what the will of the people is. So it doesn't really matter what the people think. Whosoever rules over there, if the Taliban exercises immense control on that government, then I think India will be at a very disadvantageous position.
The basic objective of the United States was to actually bring democracy to Afghanistan. They do have elections, they do have a president elected and so on and so forth, but whether that democracy holds past the withdrawal period of American troops at 14 months remains a very, very big question. Should Afghanistan collapse into what it was before 2001 under Taliban control, India will have to stay highly alert, which means our intelligence forces have to start working already to make sure we don't see a repeat of history of what happened back then. Because back then, we also know that the end of the earlier Afghan war, the militancy that had actually erupted over there, was used in many ways to push terrorists and militants into Kashmir. There's a direct connect between violence all across this arc and what happens in Afghanistan. That's very important. We do not want history to repeat. Thank you.